สวัสดีครับ Hi everybody Fairly to see you again Today I would like to share the formation of our department Anno Archaeological Field School at Wat Phu Noi in Central Thailand in the last 2 years after the pandemic of the COVID-19. Our department was established in 1955aims to educate and train a new generation of archaeologists who can work in archaeology and related discipline for the Fine Arts Department and the other organizations. Until now, the primary purpose of our program are still the same, but have a little bit changed to meet the present and the public requirements.Anyway, the core module of our program is field practice, training to generate the field archaeologists or the curators who are working both academic and applied archaeology as the officer of the government in the public and also in private sectors. For an alright, I will introduceOur annual field school, which I would like to say that is our academic tradition. And then this is the example of the our school for the last 2 years at Wat Phu Noi. What have we done for the practice and what have and what did we find for these processes? In this slide,I will starting with our introduction. Our department will conduct an annual field school to train practice on site for the primary bachelor degree in the first to third year student, including graduate students in some years, if possible. Comprised of 10 faculty members and about 100 students to join the field.At least 15 days to 18 days per term. Generally, we always do it in summer, in March, after closing the second semester. And of course, if possible, we will change the location each year to making our students meet the various experiences and manage and solve the different problems.For example, is the old memory from the excavation at Sap Champa, late prehistoric to early historic sediment in the province of Lop Buri in 1921. And on the right side is the excavation at the early historic site in the Kon Pathom province, also in Central Thailand in 2000s.Next is also from Central Thailand. This is the excavation in the Thawratthimottet site at Khit Kin in Saraburi province in 2007. And in 2012, our department conducted an investigation program at the Ayutthaya period monument at Wat Phasi SanphetIn Ayutthaya Historical Park. Consequently, the 2013 field school managed at the Thawratthi Ancient Town at Uthong, Supanburi Province, And in 2014, our students are working with the human skeleton remains at the INS cemetery site at Ban Pong Manao in Lop Buri. But after the COVID-19 pandemic started in 2020, I think we all encountered the same problems that we can run the field school regularly on site due to the mobility restriction and the epidemic problem. So we all adapted and applied technology for our learning management. And however, learning by doing is the best. So our department decided not to cancel the field school in that year, but postponed to a suitable time in November, and also reduced the 10 days from 15 to 18 days to about 10 to 12 days, and conducted it under the national and local public health mitigation. We are landed at a new normal field school. And this is our story. Back to the location of the site. Phunoy Archaeological Site, or Wat Phunoy, is a local Buddhist temple located on the undulating plain. Its size of the Chao River Basin in central Thailand. And this site is belongs to the administrative area of Ban My District, also the province of Lop Buri. In the literature review, this site was first rescued in 1990, while the local digging for the foundation of their building, they found several human remains and many artifacts. That led to the acquisition by the first regional office of Fine Arts Department at Lop Buri, under the direction of Associated Professor Surapon Nathapintu and Ajahn Puthorn Phumathon. In that year, they discovered 32 burials and could be divided into three burial phases, relatively dated to 4,000 to 2,500 before patients, because there had not been found any metallic evidence from that excavation season. And following in 1994 to 1995, led by the Italian Thai project, they conducted the second excavation and found the ending habitation layer above these burials. Based on the ceramic type and carbon 14 dating from the sampling from the nearby other sites, this can be dated to the late Bronze Age to Middle Iron Age, approximately 800 BCE to 600 CE. This slide is presenting the excavation kit in 1990. At the corner of the Uposot, Upasatha, that is a Buddhist building. They found about 32 burials there. And in 1994 to 1995, you will see the pit lighter NWT2, NWT1, NG3, TT1 square A, that's excavated by the Italian Thai project. Based on the previous results, they found the cave density dispersed in the center. And you will see in this image, we found the burial density in the left circle, and the number of burials decrease depend on the distance from the sender. like in the area B, that we found only one burials. But in the area A, they are unexcavated. As I mentioned earlier, although the primary purpose of this activity is to train the student with actual practice, we would like to have some research questions for our student to archaeological analyze and interpret based on the discovered evidence, like searching for the northern and southern variety of the sites by using an intensive surface survey to conduct the area for excavation, both in the area A in the north and the area B in the south, and also examine its relative dating and divide the cultural chronology. Our interpretation on the relationship between Putnoy archaeological sites and the other prehistoric sites in the central region of Thailand. In the last 2 years, we trained the first year student to take an archaeological reconnaissance survey within the surrounding area. They learned to consult topography maps and using the global positioning system via a mobile application to locate site. Take an intensive survey, mapping, interview with the local, collected the surface data, and classify the artifacts, and submit the archaeological report at the end. Moreover, the second and third year student, they practice to transecting walking on the area A and B, and also took the subsurface survey techniques like an auguring test and 1x1 meter test pits to show a suitable excavation area, including applied the ground penetrating radar in the sampling area to adding the experiment in field practice. This slide is present our student took an intensive survey on the area A on the north of the site and area B, and also apply the GPR instrument to using for subsurface survey. And the upper image, why they are using the hand auguring, but the soil is hard and sticky, so the auguring is not working for this size. So we change to take a test piece 1x1 meters to looking for the subsurface evidence, both the quantity and the quality, and also the stratigraphy. after we finished the archaeological survey, we found that they have some of the evidence density in the area B. So our department decided to excavate it only in zone B, where the Italian Thai colleagues partly dug in 1994 to 1995. And of course, as the excavation process, we started with reading the site and drawing floor plan. 10 of sampling excavation tent with 1 time 4 meters among the area had excavated. In first year, we found one cave in the tent number 7 to 7A. This discovery led to the 2021 excavation season. We plan to excavate in the surrounding area of the test pit number 7 to 8 to searching for more burials. And what did we find from the field season in 2020 to 2021? We found various features. The artifacts like earthen pottery shirt, a piece of baked cake crucible, bronze fragment, and the various equifacts like animal bones and shells, including floor caves that indicated to the prehistoric habitation and cemetery activity there. The sequence can be certified into two phases, like the previous study by the Thai-Italian team. And the more intense analysis and examination for the carbon-14 dating from the direct evidence like the human remains are still in process. And of course, we will publish all the preliminary results in the academic journal later. This slide is presents our students why they are carefully excavating with the human skeletal remains, with the small types of equipment like wooden and dental probe, saw brush, and air bowls. And this one is presents both the traditional drawing of the burial and feature on the left image. And the right image is showing the new technology as well as a 3D lighting scan that we use to record to the archaeological context, like the burials. And the last slide presents the two burials that we found from this field school. On the left side is the burial number 1, and on the right side is the burial number 4. So thank you for your attention, and I hope you enjoy our videos in this class. Hopefully, when the COVID-19 pandemic is ending, we will see some of you in the International Archaeological Field School that we have a plan to conduct on site in this year or earlier in next year. ขอบคุณมากๆครับ สวัสดีครับ